This year, I have decided to be more productive with my YouTube channel. For that, I will try Notion. I heard they call it all-in-one productivity system. Let's find out.
Okay. What's up, internet? I am Manish from RebellionWriter.com. Since last couple of weeks, I have been using Notion, and I'm really impressed by how we can store data in relational database format. We can even filter and sort that data to our preference.
Here I have put together this table for managing my YouTube workflow. After multiple iterations, I have settled down on this 6-column structure. Some of them are even multipurpose columns. Take this first column for example. This column looks like it holds the name of the videos, which it does for sure. But if you will hover your cursor on any of these names and click this open button, it will open up as a page, which I use for writing the ideas or the script of the videos. Let me quickly explain you the rest of the columns of this table. The next column is a status. This is a very important column for my workflow. Every content that I create goes from a series of steps. For example, initially every content is just an idea. After I am done putting that idea together, I start writing on it. It could be a script or bullet points that I want to cover in the video. After that, that script goes to copy editor's desk.
Hi, I'm the copy editor. I check the integrity of the scripts before they are published. I check things like, are there any grammatical errors? Are the syntax correct? Does the script follow all the YouTube and Google standards? I also fix the SEO, and sometimes I rewrite the entire script. Once I'm done with that, I change the status from copy edit to edited. And from there, the script goes for filming.
And during filming, we shoot and edit the video, B-rolls and screen recording. After that, we publish the video. The next column is publish date. This holds the date on which I have published the video. This helps me in keeping track on my content. Using this date, I can see how many videos and blogs I have published in a month. Let's come to the next two columns. These are very important, especially for our today's task, which is to develop a productivity template using Notion. Currently, I'm creating content in three categories, which is Oracle, Python Pandas, and Productivity. I have put all these categories as a drop-down list in this column. Similar to categories, I also produce three types of content that are listed in this column, which is Type. These three types are blogs for my website RebellionWriter.com, videos for this YouTube channel, short videos also known as Instagram Reels and YouTube Shorts. Yes, I do make those too. Then come and join me on my Instagram. Anyways, let's come to the last column, which is tags. Here I put the text that best defines the content. It helps when I have to quickly search something.
Putting together this table has already made my life a lot easier. But I'm going to make it even better by creating a template for my YouTube workflow. I have even created a wireframe diagram of how my productivity template should look like.
Take a look. I have divided the template into 4 rows. The first row will have 3 columns. The first column will hold all the scripts that I'm currently writing. This way, I never have to scroll through the table to find out which script I was writing last. Everything will be right here at the top of the page. The next column will hold all the scripts that need to be copy edited by my editor. That will save both of our time and increase the productivity. The third column will be holding all the scripts that are copy edited and ready to be filmed. This way, I will have every important material right at the top of the page for me and for my editor. Next row will have 2 columns. The first column will hold the video scripts and second column will hold the blog scripts of Oracle database. The third row will be similar to the second row, except it will hold the content related to Python programming. The last row again has 2 columns. The first column has the script from productivity category, and the second column holds all the scripts of short videos.
Anyways, so the idea is to create a simple looking template that solves the problem of my YouTube workflow, decrease the time wasted, and increase the productivity. And I guess we can do that.
Here I have a new page. Let's name it Master System. Also, give it a matching icon. already looking cool. Now let's make this page look like the structure that we just discussed. Great, now let's prettify it. Select this text writing and turn it into callout. Looking good. Now let's do the same with all the text. Let's arrange these callouts into columns as per the structure that we discussed. Now it looks like it's coming into shape, but these light bulb icons are looking boring. Let's change them into something interesting. I'll be replacing these default icons with the custom one from Notion VIP. These are free to use. I will leave the link of the icon page in the description. For the writing column, I will be using this pencil and ruler icon. Clicking on the icon will copy its link. That's all we need from here. After copying the icon, come to the template and click on the default icon. And go to link. Here, paste the link of the icon that we copied. And press submit. Looking nice. Do the same with the rest of the columns. This template is looking much better.
Now I will connect this template with the table that I showed you earlier. We will not only be bringing the data from that table into this template, but also be filtering and sorting the data based on column requirements.
Come to the first column, which is writing, and write / linked database. Here, I will select the table which has the data, and that is Content Hub. It's so out of order. Don't worry, we will fix it.
Since in this column, I only want those scripts that are being currently written, so for that, we will apply a filter on the status column of this table like this.
First, change the view from table to list. And then select filter. And add a filter. Here, I want to put the filter on status column, thus select status here. And writing here. Here we got all the scripts of my upcoming videos that I'm currently writing. We will do the same with other columns as well. Okay, let's fix it. Okay, great. In the next column, create a linked database with the same table that has our data. In my case, it's Content Hub. And then apply the filter. Again, the filter will be on a status column. But the value of the status will be copy edit. Great. Let's do one more thing. Let's make it full width. Okay, now we have more space with our template. Okay, let's do the same with the third column. Now let's come to the second row. Here things will be a bit different. Here we will be using group filter and also using sort feature of the Notion like this. So we created the linked database here. And right now this column has all the scripts from the Content Hub table. But in this column, we only want those entries whose category is Oracle and type is video. To do that, we need to put two filters like this. go to filter, and then add a filter, and this time select add a filter group. Here we want our first filter to be on category column. And the second filter on type column. And make sure that the clause between these filters should be AND. Here we got the desired result. This column is now showing the entries which refer to Oracle videos. I will also sort these entries on the basis of status. Therefore, from here, select Sort. And then select Add a Sort. And then Status. And sort them in ascending order. Let's bring the status column right here. Now all the videos which I need to do next will be on the top. Now I will repeat these same steps for remaining columns of the template like this. After adding all the filters and sorting, I have also added a banner to this Notion template, and this is how it's looking right now.
This productivity template came out really good, and I'm sure this thing will definitely help me with my YouTube workflow. Also, I use Microsoft Excel to manage my finance, and I'm planning to switch that to Notion also. So comment and let me know, how do you like this video? Would you like to watch how I use Notion to manage my finance? So that's it for this video. We'll see you soon. Till then, take care. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.